Senate Republicans hit some snags today, but they say they're still close to passing a bill to keep the government funded for the next several months. Majority Leader Mitch McConnell introduced it earlier today. Another top Republican said the president would sign it. And keeping them honest, that's a bit odd for two reasons. One, because the bill does not contain money for the president's border wall. And two, because just about a week ago, the president said this.
And I'll tell you what,
I am proud to shut down the government for border security, Chuck, because the people of this country don't want criminals and people that have lots of problems and drugs pouring into our country. So I will take the mantle. I will be the one to shut it down. I'm not going to blame you for it. The last time you shut it down, it didn't work. I will take the mantle of shutting down. And I'm going to shut it down for border security.
But we believe you.
Keeping them honest, sure seems like he won't. In fact, it almost seems like he bluffed, was called on it, and is now backing down. This does not sound like a chapter from the art of the deal, nor the kind of deal-making he promised voters.
We need somebody with great energy, with great passion, with great deal-making skills.
I'm going to make the great deals.
I am going to make great deals for our country. I mean, what I do is I do deals. I deal. I negotiate by creating leverage. So I can extract a good deal for the United States, for the people.
He said all that. Then again, he also said this.
I promise we will build the wall. And who's going to pay for the wall? And who's going to pay for the wall? Who? It'll be a great wall. Mexico's going to pay for the wall. Mexico is going to pay for the wall.
Mexico will pay for the wall.
Indirectly. That's right. The new and improved version is now Mexico will indirectly pay for the wall. And how do we know? Because the president said so. Mexico is paying indirectly for the wall through the new USMCA, the replacement for NAFTA. Far more money coming to the U.S. because of the tremendous dangers at the border, including large-scale criminal and drug inflow. The United States military will build the wall. So, who's going to pay for it? Mexico. Indirectly. Doesn't quite have the same ring, does it? It's kind of like the difference between law corrupt and community service. With me now, USA Today columnist and CNN political analyst Kirsten Powers and former Trump White House Director of Legislative Affairs and CNN political commentator Mark Short. Mark, Democrats are taking over the House a couple weeks from now. So the way you look at this now, for all intents and purposes, was this the president's last best chance to get funding for his wall?
I think it is one of the last opportunities to get funding for the wall, John. But I do think that where the administration should be focused, frankly, is to say accurately that last year they got the first new funding in 10 years at $1.6 billion. And I've heard the Democrat talking points and some that have been echoed on this network to say it's not wall. It actually is $500 million of a levee system that is 20-foot concrete wall with a road in between and another wall on the other side. It's $200 million of actual new bollard fencing on the Rio Grande River, and it's about $900 million of repairing the fences from about 8 feet to raising it to 30 feet of bollard fencing, which is what Customs and Border Patrol said they want. So I think the administration should actually be taking credit for what they got, and the new bill has another 1.6 in it. So it's actually the first new funding in 10 years that's delivering on the president's commitment to actually build a wall.
I understand what you're saying. And yes, there is funding that has been used for these border barriers, but it isn't the wall the president promised. In fact, it specifically cited that it can't be for the wall as he promised it. But I do understand what you're saying.
But John, to that point, what the president said after the campaign is Customs and Border Patrol career officers came in and said, here's the wall that we want. Here's the fencing that we want. That's the plan the administration submitted to Congress to get funding that Congress has funded. So, in fact, that is the White House proposal. That is what is actually Congress is supporting. I understand Democrats are in a tough spot because they want to say their base. We never agreed to that, but they actually did.
Look, again, Mark, I understand what you're saying. That wasn't the promise. That wasn't who's going to build the wall. We're going to build the wall, and who's going to pay for it? Mexico. It's neither of the things he promised during the campaign. Yes, that was the deal that was struck more than a year ago with Chuck and Nancy, Chuck Schumer and Nancy Pelosi, and what has been extended at least for a few more months now. Kirsten, you know, for a president who says he makes better deals than anybody for a president who said he was going to get $5 billion for the wall this time, or else. What happened?
Well, I mean, first of all, I do want to respond to what was just said. I mean, he has not gotten what he said he was going to get, and he most recently wanted $5 billion and he didn't get it. And the CBO has said that to build the wall would cost $18 billion. So let's just think about that for a minute. $18 billion for this wall that we don't even need. But he didn't get anywhere near the amount of money that he needs for the wall that he said was going to be paid for by Mexico. So I would say he's definitely failing in terms of getting done what he said he would get done in getting the deals that he needs to get done to accomplish one of his goals that he, you know, when he had both, you know, the Senate and both sides of the Congress under Republican control. So it seems like a failure. I would say it's a good failure. And I don't think that we should shame him for it, because I think it was actually very mature behavior to say, I'm not going to shut down the government because of the wall. And so I think it's turned into this thing of trying to shame Donald Trump for actually doing something that I think was mature.
Look, I think that's an important point. The government will stay open till February. If you didn't want to have a shutdown over Christmas, both sides have figured out a way to get there. At least until February. Maybe there'll be a shutdown over Valentine's Day. It will be less romantic for a lot of people. Mark, the messaging from the president in that meeting 1 week ago with Chuck Schumer and Nancy Pelosi, did that backfire on him?
Well, John, I don't think that the expectations have been raised to get to $5 billion. As Kirsten knows, yes, we had Republican control of the House and Senate, but you need 60 votes in the Senate on any spending bill. So that meant you're going to need to get at least nine Democrat votes in the Senate, which was unlikely. Having said that, again, I do think that it's something that the administration on the messaging front should be talking about what they got already, as opposed to raising expectations that I think were difficult to meet.
And Kirsten, finally, on the fact that the president claims that Mexico will indirectly pay for the wall by way of trade with NAFTA, which, by the way, is not how revenue actually works. Is that an example of deal making?
But that's what you just said, though. It's not. I don't even know how that would work. How would you even earmark that money or direct that money, assuming that amount of money came in anyway? And like I said, I just think people need to think about this $18 billion. And it's probably, if the past is prologue, it will be more than that. Because usually when the government does something, whatever they think it's going to be, it's usually at least twice as much or more. So he's saying that we're going to get some benefits from a trade deal that hasn't been ratified yet either. And then he's going to take that towards, you know, and put this towards the wall. I think people should be concerned about that.
Kirsten Powers, Mark Short, thank you so much for being with us. Happy holidays to both of you.
Thanks, John.